of our flesh, fulfilling the desires of the flesh and of the mind, and were by nature the children of wrath, even as others. But God, who is rich in mercy, for his great love, where he loved us, when we were dead in sin, when you were sorry, no nothing going for you, he made you alive. By grace you are what? Saved. Now this to me is the most amazing thing about God's love. That he did for us what we couldn't do. He made us capable, able. I mean, he just fixed us up before we even knew it. You got it. Before you knew it. And it says, by grace are ye what? Saved. What we got to do first is start depending on, some folks are worried about, do I have enough faith? Got enough faith to this and that. Don't worry about the faith. Just, it's the grace there. It's the grace there. For me to partner up with a guy who's a multimillionaire, growing up in North Tulsa over here, to partner up with him and then ride on journeys 3 or 4 or 5 hours one way and 3 or 4 hours back one way, and then open up my ears to see, how'd you do it? How you, tell me your story, tell me your life. That's grace. Amen. See, that's not me orchestrating that, that's God. Amen. Grace. Grace and favor. I had an idea that once you and I are gonna go all across America, there's no boundaries, because you got the plane. Yeah. And then he says, we can relax out in my cabin. He showed me his cabin out here over in Missouri. Oh, it's just awesome, awesome, awesome. Just awesome. And then Wes developed high blood pressure and sugar diabetes. So you know what they did? They took his pilot license away. So I'm like, the devil got in the way. So now I'm going to have to talk to Wes and say, Wes, this is how we're going to get your health back. Yeah. How we get your faith back. Because we're getting in a plane. Amen. And in 2 hours, we're going to take care of business and pick up thousands of dollars. And then we're coming back home before the day is over. Because I do believe that it's possible. Amen. It's possible. God didn't just do stuff for us to say, oh no, it's something. Something's goofed up here. This is too good to be true. No, it's going to work.
Yes.
Praise God. So it's mind over matter. Nothing matters.
Right.
We see the goal. 6 figures a year.
Yes.
Hallelujah. That's what you and I got to do, is that we got to stop looking at our sorry life.
Right.
And stop letting it tell us the score.
Mm-hmm.
This is how it's going to be.
That's right.
God says, well, above all things, I want you to prosper and be in health, even as your soul does what? Prosper. Glory to God. I put a blessing on Mark when he asked for just his hand, because I sat down and got his mind. He'll be all right. He'll be all right. Walter, too, praise God. He'll be all right. But I don't know how they came to my daughter so broke. Where did he get that idea? Praise God. So, quick sermon, when Kenny got married, praise God, I had my own house, car, furniture, the whole nine yards. Then I came to her dad and said, I want to marry your daughter. But they don't do it like that these days. Sorry. Sorry. But they kind of caught on there. But back then, wasn't that sorry? Wasn't that sorry? That's sorry. I'm sorry, you had nothing to show. Sorry. But God can give you a rebound.
That's right. That's right.
And he can make all grace abound toward
right.
you.
Amen.
Favor. Welcome to talk about the contracts he get, the jobs here, Walter and them are working. I'm just astounded.
Amen.
That, yeah, it can work. It can work. Praise God. Faith does work. But with faith, you got to put some work behind it. Faith without works is what?
Dead.
Dead but alone. God's blessed you, gave you the ability, but if you don't put no work behind it, no sweat equity in it, It won't happen, no matter how long you've been saved or what. I wish the church say amen so I can start preaching. Okay, Ephesians 2:4. God who is rich in mercy for his great love, wherewith he what? Loved us. Verse 10, that same chapter. Let's go to verse 8. By grace are you saved through faith. And that not of yourselves. It is the gift of God. Not of works, we see any man should boast. For we are his workmanship created in Christ Jesus to good works, which God hath before ordained that we should do what? Walk in them. He's purposely designed it for you to walk and exist in good stuff. Praise God. Now that verse 12, that at that time you were without Christ, aliens from the commonwealth of Israel, strangers from the covenants of promise, having no hope, and without God in the world at one time. That's all you are. But now in Christ Jesus, you who sometimes were far off are made nigh by the blood of Christ. So we're there. We have it. Praise God. We just got to figure out what I got to do. What my mind has to major on over nothing else that matters. When you do that, you got it. It's going to happen. Praise God. But sometimes we feel so loud. Give it up. Hurts too. It's too far. Too much. Too costly. Peanut butter and jelly sandwiches tonight. I got those Roman noodles these days. Roman noodles. If you have to eat Roman noodles every day to keep and spend that money that you know that you need to plant somewhere, you should eat Roman noodles every day to plant that seed that's going to come up for you. I know it ain't easy. Beans and cornbread. Walk away. No, they have beans and cornbread. I walk away and get all the time. What's the name of the bread? Water bread. Fried water bread. Hot water cornbread. It's just like eating water. And now I eat salmon and I eat whatever I want to eat when I want to eat it, praise God. Hallelujah. When Kenny and I go on vacation, my greatest wish is this, that if I had the saints with me.
Oh, amen. Praise God.
Or if the saints could see this. And then you say, see this guy right here? He makes 30 grand a month. This guy I'm sitting with makes 80 a month. It's nothing to them. It's everyday stuff to them.
Amen.
This guy sits down and says, yeah, my home in Beverly Hills. My home in Beverly Hills. I got another home in Texas, Dallas, 26. And I live back there. And it's just normal people that God has blessed. Praise God. I said, oh, if the saints could see this. Praise God. But so this is what we got to do. We got to change our mindsets. Mind over matter. I'm convinced we have a faith, praise God. If we put the work behind it, it's going to make something happen. Okay, God bless you. That's all I have, Pastor. I just wanted to share with you. We can. All our sorry life. Yeah, but that's stuff. That's where we come from. Praise God. God bless you. Open. Glory to God. Okay. Hallelujah. Thank the Lord. Hallelujah. Sometimes people don't think success goes with the gospel. It's just greed. But that's what God has given you. That's your God-given right. The seed is in you. You're going to be uncomfortable until you get it. Hallelujah. You're going to be so frustrated until you get it. And you can obtain it. But you got to put the work behind it. Hallelujah. So some of us, maybe we need to not pray to have faith, but pray to have the work. How many agree with me?
Amen.
This is what, give me the mind to do what I got to do to get over there. Hallelujah. Whether it's your health, whatever it is, peace in your home, your marriage, your finances, whatever it is, what I got to do, Lord, give me the strength to do that particular thing that you've been telling me to do. Hallelujah. And tell me in a timely fashion, give me a clear path to the answer. Let's pray that today. Can we stand together? Give me a clear path to it. Open up my eyes. Open up my mind. Show me. Hallelujah. And keep me from evil that it won't hurt me. That's all Jabez wanted. Yeah. Keep me from the evil that it won't grieve me. Enlarge my coast. Father God, your children are here, your beloved ones standing before you.
Amen.
Father, they all know the circumstances, situations in each and every life. We all are aware. The hindrances, the sin that besets us. But we also know, Father, that if we lay those things aside, put them down, we can strive and walk with you, because he that walks with you truly has fellowship with the Father and with the Son.
Yes.
Father God, we thank you for your great love, you're rich in mercy, hallelujah. You already proved that you loved us.
Yes.
Jesus died and rose again for us, hallelujah, paid the price. And Father, we know that we'll bring you great glory and great honor because you have pleasure in the prosperity of your child. So in the name of Jesus, Father, we open our hearts and our minds, hallelujah, to receive the insights, the wisdom, the how-to, the where to go, what to do. And you give favor, hallelujah, you give grace, you give glory, because we humble ourselves to know that it's Christ working in me, the will and the do of his good pleasure. We thank you, Father God, for the message of faith, the word of faith. Not only does it bring salvation, but it brings healing and deliverance for the body, for the mind, for the home. Give all your people, Father, put your blessing upon them. Your blessing is already there. But let the mind open up. Let it expand. Enlarge the coast. Show more territory. The high places of the earth to walk on. Thank you, Lord. I give you all the praise and glory. In Jesus' name, let the church say, amen.
Amen.
God bless you.